comfortable scoring within the flow of the offense. With this all-around impact, doesn't need to force things to make winning plays. But if you need him to, he can.
Hits the three-point bomb.
This has been a tremendous quarter for him. Everything he puts up now looks like it's going in.
Williams can't get it to go. New York leading by 7. Here's Junior. We saw him go on a scoring rampage last game. They get it again. Randall with the bucket.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Los Angeles has gone 0-2 from deep here. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Here's Junior, and Junior throws it down.
Boy, that was quick. Already out to a double-digit lead.
This has been a beatdown right here, possibly over before it began.
Now here's Williams. He has 6. Leonard to stop the run. It's rebounded by Barrett. New York's gone 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. And it's Junior missing. Clippers trail by 11. To the inside, Morris. And Morris throws it down.
This is the type of playmaker Lou is. Outstanding at getting it to his open guys.
Here's Junior. That one a little long.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Puts it up from 17. The Clippers grab the miss.
And that is the exact type of opportunity this offense is looking to create.
You know, if you get the ball to the right guy in the right spot, more often than not, you're coming away with points.
Now, Junior. Paul George missing from long range. And here's Junior. He's got 13. And Junior throws it down.
Yeah, we're seeing some fireworks from them already.
They established the pace. They made shots. This is why they're way out in front.
Morris outside. Leonard with the ball. He had a 33-point outing in their last game against Memphis.
Yeah, and I look at his total effect on the scoring, both as a passer and a shooter. Incredibly productive.
And a wide-open look for Junior. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Junior's got 18 points in the game.
He's been a big factor in their offense tonight, making shot after shot.
Williams finds George. Now Leonard takes the three. There we go. Now in the scoring column with that make, he is 1-for-4.
Yeah, and when you're hit, you gotta hit back.
And you know he was going to try to respond. Those threes canceling each other out perfectly.
Now, here's Junior. He's got 18. This 1-for-3. Kawhi Leonard comes up with the rebound.
Yeah, and you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
The Clippers again turning it over. So, for the Clippers, Ivica Zubac has checked in for Harold. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Williams. The Knicks also changing it up. Bobby Portis has checked in for Julius Randle, and it's Knox in for Maurice Harkins. And that was another look at the aggressive D that led to the mobile one block.
And those are plays that get you in front and keep you in front.
Now here's Junior, and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Greg, too early to start talking about MVP for this year or midseason.
You know, we've gotten to a point now where we start talking MVP at the start of the season, you know?
Yeah, right.
People just love to talk sports at this point, especially when it comes to the most prestigious individual awards out there. I think you can make a case and sway some opinions with your play this time of year, but I like to let it all play out before I start focusing on that.
Things can change in a hurry, can't they, in a season?
You yes, like they can.
Like you say, let it play out.
And really, the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly.
And stolen by Junior. On the court for the Knicks. It's Randall and Robinson at the four and the five. Junior's out there with R.J. Barrett. And it's Dotson in at the small forward position. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. Junior, in his last outing against the Suns, was a driven man. He ended the game with 68 points and seemed to pick apart the defense all night with a ton of assists. It's rare to see any player put up numbers like that. It's likely a game he'll always remember. Kevin?
Okay, David, thanks. It'll be interesting to see, Greg, how much of that performance carries over to tonight.
And, Kevin, different scenarios call for different measures. I'm sure he'll just try to provide whatever they need for the win.
Well, that's what it means to be unselfish, putting the team's interests first. As you say, he just wants to come away with the W.
Here's Williams following the basket by Junior, looking to get it going. It'll go, and the Knick lead is cut down to 12 points. The points that time coming from Lou Williams.
Using his athleticism in the paint, Lou beats everyone to the punch.
And Randall throws it down.
Oh, taking it to the rack with power.
Hammering down the two-hand slam. Pass to Morris. And Morris throws it down.
Well, Paul knows the defense is locked in on him, so he takes advantage and finds the open man.
And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Here's the thing. He's a guy who will go on hot streaks for you over a number of games.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
Outside Williams. Passes it to Harrell. A three ball. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Williams. Williams has got his fourth assist in this one.
Nice timing on the pick and roll. Williams, a solid playmaker when asked to fill that role.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. And the refs are going to rule that unnecessary contact. It's a flagrant one foul.
And Kevin, I got to tell you, he's probably fortunate to just get a flagrant one there. I mean, so much contact. The officials easily could have gone even harder on it.
Greg, I agree. He better be on his best behavior from now on. One more flagrant of any variety, and he's out of here. Jackson comes over with the double. Pass to Randall. Kicks it to Junior. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. That's on Reggie Jackson.
And this is why you must clog the lanes. Once Junior spots one, he forces you to be aggressive defensively. And you have to like the way he's attacking the defense, drawing fouls and getting himself chances at the line this quarter.
Now here's Jackson. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Tries it from the top of the key. Nice spin off the left rim and in.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
Here's Junior, and he gets it to go. Junior's got 34 points.
Strong work for him at the offensive end, helping them to maintain that lead.
George finds Harrell. Outside Williams. Jackson in the corner. Morris trying to free himself up. And there's Jackson on the assist by Williams. Jackson's got 5 points in the quarter. Looking at Los Angeles, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Grizzlies.
You know what? That's a game where the coach might just want to burn the video, because there's no question they're a better team than what we saw, but they got crushed on that night.
And obviously we know that's not how they usually play, but hey, they've got to perform better next time around.
The Knicks have made a little more than half their free throws today, 7 of 12. Here's George, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Julius Randle picks one up.
The homecoming for Paul George, playing in L.A. with the Clippers. They gave up a king's ransom to OKC. 5 first-round picks and Danilo Gallinari and Shai Gilgeous-Alexander.
New York calls timeout.
And guys, the Clippers were willing to give almost anything for PG because they basically got Kawhi Leonard in the deal as well.
And let's remember, GA, he could have been a Laker. They would have had to trade away the second pick in the 2017 draft, that or Brandon Ingram. Their loss became the Clippers' game.
And just tacks a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
That's bringing it down hard. And Harrell slams it in.
Good vision, good decision by Reggie. Pushing for a better shot, finds an open man.
Jackson comes over with the double. The pass to Junior. Three-pointer. The Clippers grab the miss. Here's George, and George with the stuff.
And this is how you score in transition. And Paul George, you just have to appreciate his hustle.
Now, here's Junior. D right on him. It's good. Junior's got 38 points.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
And this is what happens when you start to break your opponent's spirit. The resistance is no longer there.
Now, here's George. 26 points for him last game against Memphis. Just 5 on the clock. He kicks it to Morris. And Morris throws it down.
Just aggressive there. Instead of going to one of his patented shots inside, Morris just simply rises up to be free.
Good on the three-point shot.
It's just hard to believe that someone can perform at such a high level. They've got to thank him for this lead.
And it's blocked. What a play as he just snatches the shot out of midair.
And not a night he's going to want to remember. Just not really able to score the basketball.
Robinson with the block. And they'll keep possession. Morris with the bucket.
Yeah, they got into a nice flow this quarter.
New York leading by 12. It's Reggie Jackson with the rebound. Down low. It's deflected. It's stolen by Randall. Here's Junior, and Junior throws it down.
And Randall doesn't pick up a lot of steals, but he has a great nose for the ball.
And so it's Jackson who brings it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Now Harrell, 7 points in the game. Now here's Jackson. Outside Williams. Lock at 6. Knocks it loose. And stolen by Junior. Floats it up for Randall. Up high to stuff the alley-oop.
Well orchestrated. Randall was ready to receive the pass and flush it in one motion.
Clippers trail by 16. And they double up Jackson. Here's Morris. That's good. And it's Jackson with the assist that time. Morris has got 10 points in the game. Junior the pass to Randall. Junior kicks to Harkless. Now the dish to Junior. Back to Harkless. And Harkless slams it in.
And you can see the floor awareness there. Junior more than capable of...
See, look how many points I have to win the second half. This is the first half, 9.
Calls timeout. Looking back at what was a stellar career grade...
I'm 4 out of 10 from 3.
If there was one thing you could have done different, do you have anything
Maybe
on your
the
mind?
Seat. I looked at you the whole time.
For 3 points.
9 misses, free throw. Oh, you could have 2 more points.
You know, I would have loved to.
No.
Of course you always...
I only green.
So that brings the first half to a close. Knicks out front. They're up by 8. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge. Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime. And we've got third quarter of basketball for you. 2 quarters in the books. You look at Junior in this one, he's been everywhere.
The burst he's had when going at the rim has been fantastic. A lot of strong finishes.
Oh!
His activity level has
look.
Impact, and he is fearless.
Harrell is out there with Marcus Morris. Then it's Paul George.